Assalamu alaikum. In this month of Ramadan, I want to talk about some of the beautiful teachings of Islam. And nowadays people have so many questions in their minds, and that's due to the media that we are seeing so much of inauthentic information is being bombarded, and the gullible ones don't know what's true and what's not. So I thought it is a need of the hour for us to elaborate on some of the Islamic ethos so that people can get the right perspective. Today I'll be talking about the aspect of justice in Islam. During the times of Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who happened to be the Khalifa. Khalifa means he was the ruler of Arabia, and the Muslims were taking him as the single ruler. So at that point in time, there was a governor in Misr. Misr is Egypt. And the governor's son, it so happened that he beats up one Coptic Christian. Coptic Christians are those who live in Egypt. And the Coptic Christian was beaten up while he was at a race with the governor's son over the horse. So it so happened that he was so disturbed, the Coptic Christian, he goes and complains to the authorities in Misr, but people did not take up this case because, you know, he's lodging a complaint against the son of governor. It's a big issue, like even in today's time, if at all an MLA's son or minister's son does a crime, you know, how far would the victim's complaint would be taken so easily? It's very difficult, isn't it? So that's how it was. And what happened is that when the Coptic Christian did not find justice there, he goes to meet Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, the Khalifa, the ruler of Arabia, and goes and meets him and complains about the son of the governor. And guess what? The Khalifa calls the governor and his son for the meeting, and he was called to come for the, you know, for the case to be heard. And Khalifa was there, and the governor and his son, they come along with their people, and the victim is there, and the person who complained, he's also there, that is the Coptic Christian. And the case is being discussed, and Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he questions the son of the governor as to whether whatever the you know, the complainant is saying is true. And at once the governor's son says in an affirmative, saying that he had hit him. Guess what happens? Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu commands the Coptic Christian to beat up the son of the governor in the same manner, to take retribution, that is to take revenge or whatever, you know, in a way that he will be satisfied. And the Coptic Christian beat him up in front of the Muslims under the caliphate, under the Khalifa, while the Muslims were there in majority. And this is the justice of Islam. And what I'm trying to bring you all into notice is that people who think that Islamic law is favoring just the Muslims, or Islamic law would not give rights to the non-Muslims, they are totally in error, because Islam commands justice to humanity, as the Quran says in Surah An-Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 90. Allah says, "Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkari wal baghi ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun." The translation of this is, verily Allah commands you to do justice, justice to all of mankind, and show kindness to people, and give to your relatives, and stay away from obscenities and evil things and oppression. Allah is instructing you all of this so that you may remember. So what we understand is Islamic law is the one of justice to humanity. Even if the land is ruled by Muslims, there everybody is treated with equality and, you know, justice. So with this, I'm going to end my talk. I hope you all enjoyed. I would like to share some of these kind of stories and bring in the Islamic perspective so that people understand things in the right way, and this can remove the kind of misunderstanding and kind of mistrust between the communities. Thank you.